السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We present to you lesson number 834 of our daily nasiha and advice. Our topic today is the rights of animals. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أذبت امرأة في هرة, that a lady was punished regarding a cat. Sajanataha hatta matat, she would imprison it, meaning tie it, fasten it, till the cat died. Fadakhalat fiha nar, and because of that she entered Jahannam. La hiya at'amatha, nor would she feed it. Wala saqata, nor give it water to drink. Idh hiya habasata, but she fastened it, imprisoned it. Wala hiya tarakata, nor did she leave the cat. Ta'kulu min hashashil ar, to eat from whatever Allah gave the outside, and so forth. The hadith in Bukhari Sharif. Regarding cats and kittens, remember to keep it is totally permissible. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, innaha laysat binajisin, that it is not impure, it is not napak. Innama hiya min at-tawafina alaykum at-tawafat, but they are making tawaf in your house, going around and so forth. Therefore, when they jump on the sofa or carpet and so forth, it does not become napak, najis or impure. It is permissible. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is called Abu Huraira because of his love for kittens and cats, and he himself had a cat and kittens and so forth. So therefore Islam allows that. See the following hadith. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Bainama rajulun yamshi, once a person was walking, fashtadda alayhi al-atash, and he became extremely thirsty. Fanazala biran, he went down in a well. Fashariba mina, he took out water from there and he drank from there. Thumma kharaja, then he came out. After he quenched his thirst, فَإِذَا هُوَ بِكَلْبٍ, suddenly he sees a dog, يَلْهَثُ, and the dog, the tongue is lolling out, sticking out, and it is panting because it is so thirsty. يَأْكُلُ الثَّرَى, and eating the mud because, مِنَ الْعَطَشِ, because of thirst, extreme thirst. What did this person do? فَقَالْ, he thought to himself and said, لَقَدْ بَلَغَ هَذَا مِثْلُ الَّذِي بَلَغَ بِي, this dog also reached that stage which I reached, extremely thirsty, and I went down and I drank the water. فَمَلَى خُفَّهُ, so he filled his sock, you know, like a leather sock and so forth. ثُمَّ أَمْسَكَهُ بِفِيهِ, and then he held it there by the mouth, meaning that ثُمَّ رَقِيَا, and then he came up, so in such a way that he filled it up so that the dog could drink the water. فَسَقَى الْكَلْبُ, and then he gave the dog to drink. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ, so Almighty Allah appreciated that action of his. فَغَفَرَ لَهُ, Almighty Allah forgave him. Almighty Allah looks for excuses to forgive us, but we human beings, if we remain negative with Allah, this will not happen. Always remain positive with Allah. حُسْنُ ذُنِّ بِاللَّهِ وَاجِبٌ, to have positive conviction with Allah, that is compulsory and mandatory for a Muslim. The Sahaba were amazed and astonished. Qalu ya Rasulallah, after they heard this incident, they said, O Messenger of Allah, wa inna lana fil bahaymi ajra, you mean to say we get reward regarding these animals also, these dogs, these cats and everything else, wild animals? Qal, Nabi alayhi salatu salam said, this is the true Islam. Fi kulli kabidin ratbatin ajrun, in every living being that you become an asset to it, you feed it, you quench its thirst, you give it something, and you will find the reward there. All these ahadith are mentioned in Bukhari Sharif. So in Islam we don't only speak about the rights of Almighty Allah, that is first, the rights of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is second, the rights of human beings, that is third. We also speak about the rights of animals. More 1400 years ago. Hence Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha dhabahtum fa ahsinu," that when you slaughter the animal, then slaughter it in a humane manner, beautiful manner. The hadith in Abu Dawood, and give it water before you slaughter. Imagine the beauty of Islam. Let us spread Islam to all and sundry. Barakallahu fiqh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.